I'm trying to use my drill, but it doesn't work. To figure out what's wrong, and if it's a problem I can fix, I might need to go through some testing. Is the battery all the way in?
Yup.
Is the battery charged up? Well, can swap out. Grab a battery that I know just came off the charger. Still no love. Oh wait, the switch doesn't move when I push it. I engage the safety lock. If I switch that off, the drill works. After you write a program, it has to be executed in order for you to see the results. But even the best developer writes code from time to time that includes errors or bugs. Just like a broken drill, a computer program with a bug doesn't run as expected, or may not run at all. But not all bugs are the same. The process of identifying and fixing bugs is known as debugging, and it's an important skill for every programmer. There are three main types of bugs in computer programs. A program has a syntax error when it includes code that doesn't match the rules of the language. For instance, if I wrote a conditional in Python without including a comma after the if statement, my code wouldn't execute because the Python interpreter wouldn't be able to identify the end of that particular statement. It's the same thing if I misspell a word, like if I say P-I-R-N-T instead of print. Sometimes your code can comply with all the rules of the language, but still not execute successfully. For instance, suppose you include a call to a function that isn't ever defined. A function call is a valid statement, but when the interpreter tries to run your code, it won't be able to find and execute the function specified in your function call. This type of bug is known as a runtime error, because it often isn't obvious until the code is actually run. A third type of error happens when you write code that runs, but doesn't produce the results you expect. For instance, a loop that counts in the wrong direction continues infinitely, and as a result, the program never completes execution. This is known as a logic error, because while the statements themselves constitute valid code, the result of the statements isn't what you were trying to achieve when you wrote the code. Debugging is just a part of programming. Every programming language has tools available that help programmers identify bugs, and in some cases, suggest how to fix them. But using those tools successfully requires that you take a methodical approach to identifying and then fixing errors. When your code doesn't run as you expect, remember that it may contain more than one bug. However, execution will generally fail at just one point. You can work with the feedback provided by your tools to fix the indicated bug, but afterwards it's important to retest and follow up on any other error messages or other issues that crop up after that first bug is fixed. You'll need to repeat this cycle until your program finally executes successfully and works as you intend. Rather than seeing debugging as a chore, I try to look at it as an interesting puzzle to solve. I encourage you to approach debugging as an opportunity to learn more about programming in general and about the specific language you're working in. When you write code in most programming languages, you're generally just writing text. In theory, you could write your code in a basic text editor, save your code, and then use the appropriate interpreter to execute it. However, there's a wide selection of dedicated code editors, which are also known as integrated development environments, or IDEs. IDEs are built specifically for writing code in different languages. What makes an IDE special is that when it's properly configured for the language you're coding in, it can not only catch bugs, but it can help you avoid creating some of them in the first place. I'm using Visual Studio Code as my IDE, and I've installed an extension for Python syntax support. This means that whenever I open or type code in a Python file, the editor does a few things. First, it parses the syntax of the code and highlights different types of code in different colors. This feature is known as syntax highlighting, and it makes it easier to read through code and recognize what each part of each statement is doing. For instance, here the variable name value is in white, and the method names range and print are in yellow. Syntax highlighting really shines in complex code. Instead of needing to read through a wall of text that's all the same color, The different colors help you visualize the functions of different pieces of code and understand it more quickly. An IDE can also offer to finish code for you while you're typing, saving you some keystrokes and also helping you avoid spelling mistakes. This feature is known as auto-completion. I want to add another print statement at the end of my program here. So on line 3, I'm going to type P. And I see a list of possibilities that all start with the letter P. There's a lot of them. So I'll continue on and type R. And now the list is narrowed to just 5 options that start with the letters PR. And the first is the print method that I want to use. Now I could switch to my mouse and click the item from the list. But sticking with the keyboard, I can also just press Tab to select the current item in the list and move on. Then when I type my opening paren, the IDE automatically adds a closing paren for me. And it also displays a short synopsis of how the syntax works for the Python print method, in case I need to check which order the arguments go in, for instance. Once I start typing in the parens, the pop-up goes away. I'm going to say all done. Syntax highlighting and code completion are useful tools, but IDEs can do even more for developers. In many languages, an IDE can check code for bugs before you even execute it. This process is known as linting. For instance, what if I type my variable reference on line 2 incorrectly using val instead of value? Let me make that change. And then when I save that code, a squiggly line is displayed under the text val. When I move my mouse pointer over that part of the code, a pop-up explains that the variable val is undefined. My program is relatively small, just 3 lines. So it's pretty straightforward for me to scan the code and recognize that I probably meant to reference the value variable on line 1. But in a larger, more complex program with a lot more lines of code, it can take more work to trace down the source of that error and figure out how to fix the error. Here, I can edit val back to value, and then when I save my changes, that squiggle goes away and my code passes the IDE's linting process. Different IDEs are optimized for different programming languages. When you're learning a new programming language, it can be useful to research which IDEs are commonly used by developers in that language. Picking the right IDE for a language ensures that you have the best tools to write code accurately and efficiently.